Hey guys, this video is all about paper solving. We are going to see theory paper. This is the latest examination paper and the paper code is 0478/12, May-June series 2021. So if you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to get the best content for Easter now. Coming to the fourth question, three types of internet security risks are virus, spyware, and denial of service, which is DOS attack. A. Six statements are given about internet security risk. Tick to show whether the statement applies to virus, spyware, or denial of service. Some statements may apply to more than one internet security risk. So the first statement is captures all data entered using a keyboard. It's obviously the spyware which just captures all your key presses and just sends it to the person who created the spyware or something like that. And the second statement is can be installed onto a web server. It is a virus and a spyware. And the third statement is prevents access to a website. It is the denial of service attack where the attack will just flood the website with lots and lots of requests that the website cannot process, and finally the website will just crash so that the website will not be accessible for some period of time until it just recovered. And the fourth statement is malicious code on a computer. It is obviously the virus and the spyware. And the fifth statement is self-replicating. Spyware will not self-replicate. It's just a virus which will be self-replicating and will damage the user's hard drive. And sixth statement, damages the files on a user's hard drive. As said before, it is the virus. So the B subdivision is identify three other types of internet security risk, which are, there are actually many internet security risks, but the most common are that I have noted is phishing, farming, and hacking. And the C is some internet security risks can maliciously damage data. Data can also be damaged accidentally. State three ways that data can be accidentally damaged. So the first one is from power failures, when you're just doing or working on something and suddenly the power has been cut, then your system will just off suddenly. At that point of time, the data might get permanently corrupted, something like that. And the second is like when fire accidents happen, the hard disks, the SSDs will just burn off where the data can never be recovered off. And the third is human error, like we can just unknowingly delete some delete certain files. So these are the three ways that data can be accidentally damaged. So this is the end of fourth question, and let's move on to the fifth question. The fifth question is a security light system is used by a factory. The light only comes on when it is dark and when movement is detected. The light will stay on for 1 minute before switching off. Sensors and microprocessors are used to control the security light system. A. Identify two sensors that would be used in the security light system. So the conditions which they have set for the light to turn on is that when it is dark and when movement is detected. So to find whether it is dark or not, we can use a light sensor, and to find if there is any sort of movement or not, we can use a motion sensor. And the B subdivision is describe how the sensors at the microprocessor control the security light system. So first the sensor, which is the light sensor and the motion sensor, will just send the data whether it is dark or any movement is detected. All those data will be sent to the microprocessor. It will not be sent directly, but before sending to the microprocessor, the data will be converted to the digital form using an ADC, which is the analog to digital converter. And the microprocessor will compare the data from the ADC to the stored values. Like say, if the light is switched on, like say it is dark and movement is detected. Like say, if it is dark and movement is not detected, and say it is not dark, at the same time movement is detected. So at all these times, the light doesn't need to be turned on, so that there will be no action taken by the microprocessor. But if the values from the sensors are like it is dark and movement is detected, at that time the At the, at that time, what will happen is the microprocessor will send a signal to switch the light on, and then a 1 minute timer is started. So after the 1 minute timer is been completed, the microprocessor will send another signal to switch off the light, and this whole process is continuous. So that's it about fifth question. Let's move on to the sixth question.
We have a special playlist on pseudocode basics where we will be teaching you to write pseudocode from scratch. They are made into playlist and you can view them. They are short and up to the point, so you can rely upon this. We also have different playlists dedicated to increase your marks in exam. So check the playlist section in our channel page.
So the sixth question is, cookies can be used to store a user's personal data and online browsing habits. A cookie could be used to automatically enter a user's payment details when the user makes an online purchase. Describe how cookies can be used to store and automatically enter a user's payment details. So the web server will first send the cookie file to the user's browser. So the cookie file will be containing, as said, the payment details, the username, the password, and all the things. And the user's data, which is being sent as cookie, will be encrypted to be stored by the web browser in the user's hard disk. And once in future or sometime later, if the user wants to revisit the website, at that time the web server will be requesting the cookie file from the browser, and the browser will just search for the cookie file and will send it to the web server, where the web server can access the data in the cookie stored and then can automatically fill in the entry details and then log in you into the website or do things with it. And the B subdivision is, explain why a user may be concerned about their personal data and online browsing habits being stored in cookies. The problem is that the user does not see what information is stored or might be collected, and the profile could be built about the user that could expose a user's identity, and the computer can also be hacked to obtain data stored in cookies, so payment information could be stolen and used by a third party. So this is the end of sixth question. So let's move on to the next question. So the seventh question, Jolini uses HTML to create a website. She separates the HTML into structure and presentation. A1, give an example of HTML structure. So an example of HTML structure would be margins, padding, and all those things. Both are right, you can write any of it. And the second one is, give two examples of HTML presentation. HTML presentation, we can say like font color, font size, font style, and background color, background image, all sort of things. So anything is acceptable. And the B subdivision is, explain why Jolini separates the HTML into structure and presentation. So the advantage of it is that she can easily change or edit the style of the web page, and she can also add new content and apply the same style easily. And she can also reuse the presentation style for other websites. She doesn't have to create from scratch the whole thing. And CSS can also be used to create a template or style sheet. I have said the four. I have said all the four things, but writing two is enough to get the 2 marks out of it. Coming to the last question of this paper, which is the 8th question. A keyboard is a type of input device that can be used to enter data into a computer. Complete the paragraph that describes one method of operation for a keyboard using the most appropriate terms from the given list. Not all terms in the list need to be used. So the key terms which I have said are binary, breaks, calculator, character, circuit, current, information, network, press, processor, signal, and switch. So let's start. A keyboard has a key matrix underneath the keys. When a key is pressed, it presses a switch. So the keys will act as a switch that completes a circuit. So at the time, so this allows current to flow. The location of the key press is calculated. The location of the key pressed is compared to a character map. Some of you may get confused with whether it is information or a character, but what basically is in the keyboard is just characters, right? So it's going to be a character map to find the binary value of the key that has been pressed. So if you have filled all these correct keywords, all these key terms in the correct order as I have did here, you can easily grab 6 marks out of this. So yes, we have come to the end of this paper. Hope you understood. If you have any doubts, just comment below. And thank you. As always, keep supporting us and subscribe. Thank you. If you are new here, this channel is all about educative stuffs. So don't forget to subscribe, hit that notification bell, and smash that like button for instant updates.